There is a question from Techno India, Salt Lake City, but I was just there 2 days ago. Hello, over to you.
Hello.
Yes, Professor.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Techno India.
Yes.
Basically, a 21 faculty member has been registered for this particular course. And most of them are from a little bit non-computer science background and having very little bit use of computer and other smart devices. So they are quite little bit confused with the so many platform. So already we had a talk in the last discussion with you that you are preparing for a single platform to be accessed for all delivery and all content.
Yes. But
that is only one issue with our faculty members.
As of now, they will be required to use two platforms. One is the Moodle, which will be used largely for assignment submissions and discussion forum. We have decided to use Moodle. But for viewing the videos and for online multiple choice questions to be answered, quizzes to be answered, we'll be using IIT Bombay.
Okay.
Right.
Also, we have to use the wiki as well, no?
Wiki is part of the Moodle. Wiki is not a separate separate software platform. So, you log into the Moodle and you will have access to the wiki.
Right, sir.
Yes. But let me further add that if participants are confused, they are probably confused because they have never been exposed to these kind of platforms. So, some confusion
That is true, sir. That is
confusion is legitimate. But let me tell you that with some effort in the initial period and subsequently with the assistance during face-to-face interaction, you will be able to come over these problems that the people face. And I am sure from the third week onwards, they will be handling these platforms very comfortably.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Pullareddy Engineering College. Yeah, over to you.
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Myself, Harinath Reddy, workshop coordinator for this FDP, sir.
Yes. Hello. Yes, go ahead, Dr. Reddy.
Yes. Sir, we raised a query yesterday, sir, that on 15th May, we do have an MCET exam that is for Telangana, which was scheduled already on 2nd May, but due to unavoidable some reasons, they have postponed it to 15th May. Hence, we are unable to conduct it on May 15th. This is one important problem for us. So far, the questions raised by other colleges, I came to know that the content will be copied or stored in the website. So that can be checked out later.
Yes.
So, is there any other day for us to have an interaction?
No,
like that, sir?
We will still continue to have our interaction on 14th, 15th only. What I suggest is, you may request the participants from your remote center to come on 14th and do majority of the activity on 14th itself. Then whatever remains, the remaining activity they can do either individually or small groups by observing any interactive session that we have on 15th, which will be recorded.
So we have to. Okay. So we have to tell all the participants to go through their themselves by going through all these recorded material.
That's right.
And another question. Of course, this is our the seminar gallery, and for the that is computer center. Do we need this AVU software, sir, or any that? That is to be available in the center? Is
no,
it compulsory?
No,
or,
no. AVU is required only for the interactive sessions if and when they are there during the face-to-face interaction. But when they go to the lab, you don't require an AVU facility in the lab at all. They should be just working in the groups coordinated by you. That's it.
Okay. Sir, and another small request, sir. Some 3 to 4 faculty members, so they are putting up request to me that for one day they are unable to attend face-to-face interaction on one day. That may be on 4th or 5th June like that due to their valid reasons what they are saying. So can we suggest them to go through the recorded lectures, sir?
I would strongly suggest that don't make an exception at the beginning. So don't make any announcement. However, when they are unable to come, ask them to put up a note telling you why they are unable to come. And if the if you believe that the reason is legitimate, tell them that you will seek permission from the coordinator, from me, which I am already giving you. But don't tell them in advance. But tell them that if they are absent, they will have to compensate for it immediately thereafter by understanding what was done on that day here.
Okay. So we have to make to be ready with the material which they are absent on that day.
I'll tell you, Dr. Ed, my worry is that if you make any such announcement at the beginning, then even those who do not have any other activity on those days, but suppose some activity comes up, say a friend's marriage happens on a Sunday and he comes to know about it later. Now, what he will think, a colleague who is participating, he will think that, in such case, you permit me to, permitted someone else, so you will permit me also and then I will go and attend that marriage. So we do not...
Till now, I didn't permission, sir, because we need to clarify from yourself.
No, please clarify to them that this request has been put up. And Professor Phatak has agreed to consider it, but at this juncture, he is not making it possible for anybody to be exempt. They will have to do the necessary work, but he is trying to consider whether such work can be done subsequent to that day, later on one's own. That is the only possibility.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Another clarification.
Yes.
We need, sir.
Yes.
How to ensure that each and every participant is doing the activity and how the coordinator is to be monitor all those things? How to monitor all those content prepared by the participant? Because in one letter, it is mentioned that the coordinator will be taking or monitoring all the activities done by the participant. As a coordinator, how to check it?
You cannot monitor the activities that the participants do online, obviously, because you have no control over that. The online activities are being monitored by us. Both the platform Moodle and IIT Bombay X actually have event logs. So we know, for example, when exactly a participant submitted an assignment, date and time is known. We know when exactly a participant viewed the video. We know exactly when a participant gave an online multiple choice quiz. These events are being logged by the platform and these logs are analyzed by us. In addition, we'll be requesting participants to maintain a professional diary of the workshop where they will be required to record what time and what date they did what. It is entirely up to them. You don't have to coordinate or you don't have to supervise or any such thing as the workshop coordinator. It's not your job. But they will be submitting such diaries and which will be automatically validating by analyzing the log records. All that you need to ensure is that when they come for face-to-face interaction with you during those 3 weekends, that is the time when I would expect you to help coordinate their activities and monitor their presence and participation. Is that fair?
Okay, sir. So in all those for 6 days, I'll be there for them to accompany all those.
Correct.
Okay. One more thing, small question, sir.
Yeah.
For example, there will be deadlines for the assignments now, sir.
Yes.
So if some people ask us, so can we send, because maybe some other regions, they are unable to send it by deadline. But immediately after that date, they are going to submit. Is it possible for them?
No, it is not possible. And for the online submissions, you will notice that 8 to 10 hours of work which they have to do in one day, we are actually expanding that one day to one full week. Now, during that week, they can complete that assignment on the first day itself. For quizzes and other things, we'll typically have a deadline which will permit them physical 3 to 3.5 days of work for every assignment, even for multiple choice. No. Even our surveys, which we'll be releasing tonight, for example, They will have Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and up to Tuesday, Tuesday noon to submit. Now, once you give this kind of deadline, the deadline becomes sacrosanct. It will not be extended even by 1 second. Online assignment okay. deadlines are hard deadlines.
Okay. Sir, in earlier questions raised by other, that is remote center coordinator, so we, can we get the list of activities to be monitored by workshop coordinators?
Yes, they will be communicated before the face-to-face activities of that particular week. So, for example, when next week, weekend you have the face-to-face activity, Jai Krishnan and Prasanna Murthy will be preparing a handout for you specifically, which they will be sending it to you ahead of that, much ahead of that activity.
Okay, okay, sir. So, for your information, we have 69 participants, out of which 16 were outside participants, sir, in our college.
Very good. Very good.
So, and this is the first workshop, and as a remote center, it is the first workshop for us. So, we are expecting very good response even from other colleges also. But as of now, we got 69 at present.
Very nice. Thank you so much for your enthusiasm.
Yeah, so
JK wants to make one more small point.
So, you asked about how you can monitor. So, one place where we would request you to actually do monitor is in the wiki activity, because people are doing it for the first time. So, a cursory glance into the wiki pages. Have people submitted it? Are they having problems? So, all these could be taken well in advance before the face-to-face interaction. And during the face-to-face interactions, if there are some queries, you could discuss with the group and put these questions to us directly during the face-to-face interaction. Also, if you actually see the discussion forum, so we are also users of these, we are also, initial users of these kind of technologies. But there are many other faculty colleagues who are already participating in these courses, who are actually very well versed with these technologies. And I saw almost 10 to 15 explanatory posts with screenshots, with detailed write-ups on what exactly has to be done and what all things have to be done by put up by the participants of this community. So, first, always take the help of the community. If it is not getting solved over there, then you always have the face-to-face interaction where you can directly ask the instructor. We are all equals when it comes to use of ICT. So, we, I do not say that I am an expert, but there are even more better users among yourselves. Okay. So, please make use of these expertise, and that is what we call a collaborative community, which is the main driving force of such a faculty development program.
He was primarily interested in knowing what is his direct responsibility for which he will be accountable. Okay. Thank you so much.
Sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Let us go over to RVS College of Engineering and Technology. Good afternoon, and over to you. I cannot get your audio. I'm sorry, but your audio is not, I cannot hear.
You're not audible, sir.
You please cross-check your line input and other AVU parameters. I can see you, but I cannot hear you at all. Don't worry, we'll come back to you. Please try to resolve the problem by figuring out your AVU connectivity. Let me go to R.C. Patel, Institute of Technology.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
So my question is, how the activity on the Moodle will be graded?
The activity on the Moodle will not be graded directly, but the submissions will be graded. The multiple choice quizzes will be graded, and the submissions will be graded through a combination of peer assessment and direct assessment. So we will have a mechanism to do that.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Right.
Over to you.
Thank you. No, this is where we just went. Yeah. So, Krishna Institute of Engineering and Technology. Over to you, Krishna Institute of Engineering.
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Hello. Good evening, sir. Sir, my question is that, because in this workshop, some participants are from outside of the computer stream. So they are facing some problem for handling the model. So could you send some video to operate the model?
Moodle has nothing to do with computer science. Moodle is a tool which is being used extensively by teachers of even high schools and so on. In fact, the best way to know about Moodle is to visit the Moodle site itself and look at all the Moodle documentation. So, there are also YouTube videos on Moodle.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more question, sir. Sir, after 10th of July, we have to make a team. We have to assign a team. So, what is the role of the team? What the team have to do and what the workshop coordinator have to do for that?
The team and what is the role of organization?
Which team you are talking about?
So, the participants making a team.
The role of the coordinator is merely to coordinate the team formation and to ensure that the members of the team sit together during face-to-face interaction. These teams are to be formed by participants. The coordinator will not do anything about that. So, when the coordinators come together, that is the reason why we are forming the initial groups in Moodle itself based on their domain. Now, there may be, for example, 7 people from one domain and only 3 from another domain or whatever. When they come face to face, they will be finally forming the teams
for group activity.
Now, those group activities will be indicated what group activity is to be done. In that group activity, it is not that teams sit individually and separately. The entire class will sit together. But the members of the team are expected to sit next to each other because they have to discuss the problem that is being solved first individually and by the teams. The role of the coordinator is only to facilitate such teams to sit together in the session which requires team activity. That's all.
Okay, sir. So, one more question. If regarding the workshop, some participants is absent or is not doing his assignments, so there is any role of workshop coordinator for that?
Well, the coordinator should merely report such observation. We will independently know if the assignments are not submitted, and we cannot do much except to write a small letter of reprimand and refuse to give the certificate which will be recognized by AICT. That's all. But this time we will be very strict in issuing certificates unless all the assignments are done in time and unless there is some basic minimum score in the multiple choice quizzes and the peer assessed submissions. And a person just because registering or enrolling will not be entitled to get a certificate. That much is very clear. So what you can do is you can help us by giving us inputs on whether the participants are not participating properly in face-to-face interaction and so on. And we'll factor that while taking a decision on giving the certificate.
So, one more question. So, after submitting the assignment by the participants, who will evaluate the this assignments? Means the project workshop coordinator have to evaluate from your side, the answer will be evaluated.
I have answered this question if you have been listening to the previous discussion. Most of the assignments will be, if they are multiple choice quizzes, they are automatically graded. If there are assignments of longer inputs, then they are graded by peer assessment. So every participant will have to submit the assignment and assess some 3 or 4 other assignments. That is to be done by every participant. The workshop coordinator has no role in this. Only the final team assignment that is submitted by the participants after completion of the 10 weeks of online activity, we would expect workshop coordinators to go through those team assignments. So, for example, if there are 60 participants at your place, there will be maybe, let's say, 15 to 20 teams. Now, these 15 to 20 assignments which are submitted by them, we do not expect a very detailed, elaborate assessment because they will be in different domains. But we will supply some qualitative parameters and the workshop coordinators will be expected to submit independently 3 category classification of these 15-20 assignments that are submitted from their remote center. Namely, they are excellent, they are okay, or they are poor. And for that, you don't have to be knowledgeable in that particular domain or something. You will be able to assess based on the parameters that we'll submit. It will not require more than 3 to 4 hours of work, which can be done over 2-3 days after the end of this FDP.
Thank you, sir.
Right. Tyagarajar College of Engineering. Yeah, over to you.
Good evening, Prof. Sir. Good evening, Mr. Jayakrishnan. Sir, I must thank you for your patience in listening and answering the question for the past 2 hours. Thank you for that. And I have issues and clarifications to be made, sir. Yeah. And as raised by NIT Trichrapalli, I need to have the issue of the election to be conducted on May 16th. And so the attendance might not be good on those weekends, especially May 14th and especially on May 15th. And some of our participants are going on election duty also on May 15th. So please provide some other alternate to them. And the next thing that I would like to say is, ask is, what is the point of contact for IIT Bombay during the online activity sessions, sir? Because we would meet you during face-to-face interactions, but on the other days, which is the point of contact, sir?
The e-outreach. I believe that the point of contact has already been communicated. What I'll do is I'll request my workshop manager, Mr. Mahendra Parmar, to once again communicate to all RC coordinators and workshop coordinators. But our FDP brochure itself tells you the phone line numbers, but Mahendra, are we also giving them any additional numbers or email ID? Yeah. So there is a workshop team member phone number plus the email. Email is asynchronous communication is the best way of communication, so that your mail will always be responded to. So, as a RC coordinator or workshop coordinator, when you raise a query, it will be answered with priority.
Yes, sir.
If it is related to this FDP, any
because
point
I have written
you...
a mail to eoutreach@iitbombay.ac.in, huh. And I have not got reply.
It's
eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in.
Regarding the registration of one of the participants, he has newly...
Have you received a
request? Okay, sir. And yeah. One more thing, sir. The session, the last date for the registration is supplied by today, but the online activity starts by May 2, and some of our participants are not aware of these ICT tools and they are out of these computer streams. And they feel that they are left behind.
Yes, you are right. So I will react to this question in 2 different ways. Number one, if it is known that the course starts from 2nd May, why did they wait till 6th May to register? They could have registered earlier. The last date is given merely as a facilitation for some peculiar reason. They are unable to register early, they should register late. Second, in the first week, we do not have any graded assessment. There is no graded quiz, multiple choice quiz or anything which will impact either their performance or their getting the certification. The first week is merely an exploratory week. Second, the submissions which they have to do in the first week, which all are entry surveys. In fact, let me make an announcement. I have sent a mail to everyone that we will release the entry surveys at 8 p.m. tonight, and we will expect them to, the original date of submission was indicated as 8th May. What we can do is, we will wait till the midnight today, and we will release the surveys tomorrow morning, and we will extend the submission date to Tuesday night. That means they will have Saturday, Sunday, Monday and Tuesday to respond to these preliminary surveys. These do not require any extensive studies. They just have to respond to certain entry level questions. The real work will start from the second week onwards. So I don't think we are putting people at any disadvantage, even though they have no exposure to computers.
Okay, sir, thank you. And I got one more clarification, sir. Yes. There are few faculty members, even in our institution and other institutions, who have newly joined and have not got their ID, some alternative ID card, if this is going to be the case.
They can upload the offer letter itself, that is good enough. If they just upload the offer letter, we will accept it for the time being. And we will validate their registration immediately, no problem. You see, we have to have some mechanism to confirm that the participant is a teacher, where the FDP is directed towards teachers.
All my last request, Pramit.
Yeah, please. There is a delay.
Yes, sir. This is a special case of, because I even encountered such a case in this FDP. So that I posted this question.
Okay. So that is okay. You can go ahead. Let me go back to RVS.
And request in such the usage, the sustainability and dissemination seems to be a bigger problem, because it sustains for a course or 6 months. Again, after that, while they lose interest in them, and the dissemination is a greater problem. Can this, I request you to include some elements of motivation that makes the participants to sustain and disseminate what they have learned from this workshop. So that's my humble request to you.
We will be addressing these issues in the last portion of this workshop, namely building and nurturing collaborative communities. We'll elaborate this part later. Okay, there are still so many people who have these questions. So, let me start interaction with RVS College once again. Over to you, RVS College.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, in our center, there are registered above 100 participants.
Good number.
Sir?
Yes.
Yeah. In that 100 participants, 10 participants, nearly 10 participants are external participants.
Uh-huh.
But we don't have track details of that external participants, whether they need accommodation or some other things. We don't have enough details. Hello?
Are you the RC coordinator? Because RC coordinator can see the details of all the remote center, all the participants who are not from that institute.
Oh, yes, sir. For workshop coordinator, we don't. Details are not shown.
In fact, workshop coordinator need not bother about issues such as registration and transport and accommodation, etc. That is precisely what is expected to be done by RC coordinator. Workshop coordinator is supposed to ensure that the actual workshop is conducted properly, that's all. So, better, but after all, your RC coordinator is your own colleague. So, best way is to talk to the RC coordinator and find out whether everything is well or not, that's all.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Right. Thank you. Let me go to Phenolex Academy. I believe it is Ratnagiri. I had visited that college long time ago. Over to you, Phenolex.
Hi, sir. Sir, I had two questions, but I got the answers of the both the questions in previous discussions. The first question was about whether it is required to have a lab in a classroom. So answer is there is no need of computer lab or face-to-face interaction. Right. And the second question is about the software requirement during the 2 hours in computer lab. Again, the answer is no software requirement. Okay. But when I see, when I saw the syllabus, there is a one CMS called as Drupal. So without having any kind of software, how the participant will work with that Drupal?
These participants are not expected to work extensively with Drupal. What is expected is to give them an exposure to Drupal, which we will be giving both through pre-recorded video lectures, and we will make a Drupal site available for them to explore Drupal. So Drupal is not going to be extensively discussed or used in this FDP, except that they will be told about Drupal in the proper context. So don't worry on that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Right. Thank you. CDAC Noida. I think this was one remote center which had a problem of some kind. Over to you, CDAC.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. Yes. Yes. Good evening, sir. Sir, we have a query for face-to-face interaction, and as we have learned through this session that we can go through recorded version also. But my query is, sir, can we do all session for recorded version or for one or two only?
Can you repeat the question?
Sir, my query is that can we do all the sessions, face-to-face sessions, through recorded versions?
No, that is not possible. I will tell you that there will be a portion of activity which will be a group activity, and that group activity will have to be conducted face-to-face. What I suggested is that we will keep the recorded version available so that participants can see the recorded version, do individual activity that is suggested in that recorded version, but they must come back to you in small groups where you should get the group to face-to-face activity in groups conducted. There is no choice. Now, this can be done on any alternate day in the subsequent week as per the mutual convenience of participants and your place.
Okay, sir. Okay. Let us, my query is basically that can we do all the live sessions face to face? Can we, in spite of all live sessions, can we do recorded version and give the activity on consequent days?
So they will do the live sessions,
recorded. Selling
no. Yeah, yeah, absolutely no problem. You are most welcome.
We can do one or two activity, because as we have also requested and sent a mail that for 25. We can go for recorded version, sir, only.
Yeah, it is perfectly fine. You decide how we wish to conduct that activity. The group activity has to be conducted by you. If you cannot conduct it on the date on which we have announced this, you can conduct it later and use the recorded version for the other part. No problems at all. That's perfectly fine. Basically, you have to decide this in consultation with the participants who are registered for at your center, and ensure their attendance and participation whenever you decide on an alternate date for the group activity.
Okay, sir. Right. And sir, one more query is,
Yes, please go ahead.
Sir, one more query is that should we need to send attendance?
Yes, you have to send the attendance when people come for face-to-face portion.
Let us. I have gone recorded version.
For recorded version,
is it not?
Yes. Whatever be the version that you use, whenever people attend an activity, you will have to submit their attendance. No, they will not be present. By the way, if your question relates to some days, it's okay. But this should not be done for all the three face-to-face interaction. That is not correct. Only in case you have a specific problem on any one day which cannot be solved. Only for that, for example, Tamil Nadu has elections and there may be people who are on election duty who may not be able to come. So only under such circumstances, we are saying you may permit use of recorded version, etc. But this is not a replacement for normal face-to-face dates which have been given. So the three Saturday Sundays which have been defined are the 3 days of face-to-face interaction. I am answering this question as an alternative only if your center has huge problem and prior engagement of something else for which the center cannot just conduct this face-to-face activity. Only then the alternatives can be used, not otherwise.
Oh, okay, sir.
Right. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Let me go to KLE Society's College of Engineering, Belgaum. Over to you, Belgaum.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, I am Vidya Hadimani, workshop coordinator. Sir, I have a query that can a non-faculty, a system administrator of our own college, can he register for this workshop? He is interested.
We have this dilemma even in the previous workshops. Personally, I am all in favor of him registering. But I do not see how I can give him a participation certificate which is recognized by AICTE for faculty development program. Of course, if he wishes to attend, he should enroll, he should register, he should benefit from all interaction. But we will not be able to give a certificate of participation in the same sense. I may consider giving him a separate participation certificate from IIT or something like that. Sorry?
Honor code certificate.
So that
will he give the certificate then from the principal, IIT?
No. IIT principal, I mean IIT director does not issue any certificate to anyone. We will be giving him an honor code certificate for completing the online FDP program from IIT Bombay X. But there will be, it will not be at all equivalent to participating in a proper FDP. That is not possible. I am planning to run a separate workshop or program, training program for all systems people across the country because their help and their assistance is required. But this is not that program.
But sir, he is finding difficulty in registering himself.
Yeah.
He tried registering with the option non-faculty.
Yeah, because...
But he couldn't...
So please tell him to wait. Subsequently, we will be announcing a training program of a similar kind, but meant for system administrators, software engineers and other people who help us in doing our educational activity. There will be a separate program for them. I will get it recognized by AICTE and we will announce that program. We will probably run it around November, December sometime. So please ask him to wait and have patience.
Yes, sir, surely. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Over to you.
BMS, College of Engineering, Bangalore.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Ashok.
Yeah.
Sir, I have registered even as an individual participant.
Perfectly fine.
Coordinator job.
Yeah.
I'm finding one difficulty here.
Yeah.
I'm not able to use as a board, as a dual thing, like as a coordinator and as a participant. Even I had, you know, mailed to your also. I'm not finding that option. Which your option?
There is no real option. There is nothing like there is nothing like a coordinator option. When we form a group, the Moodle group does not recognize anyone as a coordinator. For Moodle, all group members are same. So it will not recognize you or me or anyone either a coordinator or something. We are all participants. But you will be able to communicate with all group members any which way. The point is, you know that you are the coordinator, others don't. So when you initiate a communication to all members of the group, when you write that communication, you write that as coordinator, in which case it will be understood to be a coordinator's mail. Whereas anything else that you wish to observe as a participant, you write it without the title coordinator. That is the best we can do.
Other thing is, sir, like as earlier coordinators, you know, noted, I could not hear that your answer, that most of our participants are, you know, non-users of ICT. They are actually new to that. I am getting, you know, one call after their call for their queries actually. They don't know how to even feed the initial data, even their name and about them. They are finding a lot of difficulty in this.
Yes.
So instead of just sending the plain mail, can you mail, you know, like simple videos, step-by-step procedure of simple video where, you know, they can just follow it up. Simple videos like how we get on YouTube.
Yeah.
Go here, click, type.
It
will be very user-friendly.
I note your point. Unfortunately, we are too late in life to do that now. But the suggestion is well made. And what we will do is, we will prepare such short videos which will help complete novices also to work on, let's say, simple things like registration, uploading files, etc., etc. I get your point. The only hope that I have now is that while some of the colleagues may not be familiar with ICT, but they being faculty members in professional colleges, they will have professional help from either their colleagues or their students, and they should be able to overcome the initial problems. But you are very right, in the first week and even in the second week, there will be plethora of queries and questions and doubts that they will have. In fact, in the first face-to-face interaction, you may have to spend half an hour, 1 hour actually solving these problems for them. So in short, you will be playing these 1 or 2 minute videos to multiple people on that day. But the point is well made. We will take cognizance of that. And in the future editions, we will make these short videos wherever relevant. Thank you very much.
One more question, simple one.
Yeah.
Like we are collecting 1,000 rupees from the participants.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, yes. Go ahead.
Is there any split up of expenditure for 1,000 rupees? Even if, of course, if you even you want to give it as an honorarium to the non-teaching staff,
huh.
Is there any ratio?
We are leaving it entirely to the remote center coordinator, remote center workshop coordinators and remote center management. And the reason why we are charging this 1,000 rupees is because we believe that there is no value in a free lunch. That means if people are participating, they should pay something. But this money, you don't have to pay anything to IIT Bombay. We are not running it under IST. This program has been approved directly by AICT. So there is no fees to be paid by us. And as I said, we have been supported by some funding from SAP. But in future FDPs, there will be a component that they will have to pay to remote center as well as to IIT Bombay. So that will be the next version. Only this version we have got some funding support. Right. Okay. Thank you so much. Let me go to Government Engineering College. Where is this? West Bengal, West Singhbhum.
Jharkhand.
Oh, not West Bengal, Jharkhand. Yeah, hello, over to you.
Good evening, sir. First of all, let me thank you for giving us this opportunity to be associated with one of the most renowned institutions of our country. And we are extremely glad to be part of this program. Sir, we are currently facing two issues. I would like to draw your attention on that. Today, I have called many times, actually few institutes around our suburb. They are trying to register themselves under this remote center. But the problem which they are facing is their location is not coming. During the time of registration, they are from institute from a place which is in Jharkhand named Ramgarh. Their location as well as their institute name is not coming at their drop down window. So due to this, almost 20 odd participants are unable to register themselves since yesterday. So I have tried to call at administrative number, which has been given a few times, but due to some technical issues, I didn't able to catch up. And that is one problem. And along with this, I have two, three questions. One is, among these three face-to-face interactive sessions, is it necessary to attend all the face-to-face interactive sessions for the participants during this FDP program, or he can skip one or two if there is some serious concerns?
Let me answer both the questions. Number one, if they don't find their own college in the drop-down menu, there is an option called Other. They should choose that Other option. And they should just write down the name of their college and register.
So I would like to interrupt because what the problem they are facing is they are not getting the other option as well. Just a few minutes back before getting this face-to-face interaction, I have got call from their side. They are not getting other options as well. They are getting all other colleges in Jharkhand, but the colleges in Ramgarh, around Rachi, they are not getting those colleges. They are getting colleges like CIT Rachi, all other colleges, BIT Mishra, BIT Sindri, but Ramgarh is not coming up in the pop-up window. Along with this, other option is also not there.
Okay. Can you do me a favor? If those people are in touch with you, collect their email IDs and send those email IDs to us. Even if the last date or time
all
is
right,
passed,
definitely, sir.
I will try to do something about them over the weekend if possible by requesting my team to handle it at the back end. Of course, if it is not possible, I would like a personal regret mail to them requesting them to attend the subsequent FDP which will be continuing to conduct. So ask them not to worry, but we'll try to do the best that we can. I'm just talking to my back-end team, and if they can do that, that is nice. But in the meanwhile, if you are in communication with them, please just collect their email IDs, just list of email IDs, and send them to us, and we will see if we can do something about it.
Definitely, sir.
Right. And the second question was about face-to-face.
Actually, I would like to know.
Yeah, face-to-face interaction is an integral part of this FDP. A 4-week FDP is required to have 1 week of face-to-face interaction as per AICT approval. This 1 week of face-to-face interaction, we have broken into three parts, which are 3 weekends. So these are obligatory. If people don't attend that, all the group activities we plan to conduct as a part of pedagogy training will be conducted during those face-to-face activities. If they are not physically present for those face-to-face activities, we cannot consider the participation in the FDP to be complete. So it is an obligatory requirement. It is not an option.
All right. Thank you very much, sir. Excuse me, sir. I have one last question.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Sir, can you give me a brief idea of payment, mode of payments, which has been nothing has been disclosed. The mode of payment, the participants is to pay. Should they pay directly to the remote center, or there would be any link via which they will be paying?
No.
IIT Bombay or.
No, I don't know why there is confusion. It was very clearly stated in our announcement. The money is to be paid to the remote center directly on the first day at the beginning of the face-to-face interaction. There is no money collection mechanism that we have put. So obviously the remote center should give them a receipt when they give that money and utilize this money for providing all the facilities over the 6 days of interaction. That's all is expected. IIT Bombay has nothing to do with either that payment collection or receipt or the utilization. You don't have to send any utilization certificate, nothing, because we are not funding you. Later on in subsequent FDPs, when we conduct the future FDPs, there will be a fees component for IIT Bombay and a fees component for remote center. At that time, we will announce a web portal for payment for IIT Bombay portion, but the portion to remote center will have to be paid to the remote center directly. Since all remote centers do not have a common mechanism of such fees collection, we have said that let such payment be made at the time of first face-to-face interaction to simplify matters. That's all.
Thank you very much, sir. It's been nice talking to you.
There is some clarification which my manager has just given me. Number one, the other option is very much there. So I do not know why they are not able to see that. We just check the registration form. If you click on the college, there is the other option. Second, if they are having any problem, one simple advice is let them choose your remote center name as their college itself and let them register.
All right, thank you very much. Actually, they have sent me the screenshot too, where they are not getting the other option.
They have sent, yeah.
That is why I am a little concerned. Thank you very much, sir. I would definitely inform them to select our college.
Right, thank you. Ramgarh.
Hello, good evening, sir.
But Ramgarh is not there.
Kalyani Kulkarni from PVG College.
Good evening, Kalyani.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Greetings from PVG College. This workshop is itself is very, very innovative. And thanks to you and your team for involving us. And definitely, almost all queries and my doubts are cleared. And I think this is time to work. And due to your efforts, definitely we'll become smart teachers. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much and all the best. Thank you for participation.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Let me go over to RBS Engineering College. This is
Hello.
Agra.
Good evening, sir. Myself, Namrata Gupta, workshop coordinator. And I have a query regarding Moodle assignment.
Yes,
so I have through my college link and then further I got, there are so many links for the particular participants in the wiki pages. In the wiki pages, there are so many links for a single participant.
If I understand it correctly, we have initially populated only the one name that has been registered at our end. So, So what you can do is, as a remote center coordinator, you can remove any of the duplicate links and ask the participant to use only one link. This may happen because he or she might have edited that page and added their name again. So this is the duplicate. I mean, it is understandable. They are getting familiarized with the technology. So, as a coordinator, what you can try to do is remove all the duplicate entries and ask them to use only one link.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
And thank you for participation from your institution. Let me go over to IES College of Technology, Bhopal. Over to you. Sorry, your audio also has a problem. I cannot hear you.
Sir, your audio is, you're not audible, sir. Yeah, can you check?
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, please go ahead.
I would like to ask some questions about there is having discussions for the here is the watch to submit on the put it some doubt on which. So they have a fear of about it.
I'm sorry, but your audio is not clear at all. It is breaking and it is very low. I'll request to check your audio separately by arranging a separate test session. But meanwhile, you can post your question on chat. So we'll look at the chat and try to answer it. But I'm sorry, I'm not able to hear you. I can see you very, very clearly. So your video is very good, but audio has a problem. We'll get back to you later. Let me go over to Shanmuga College of Engineering at Salem.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Most of my questions are answered, sir.
Very good.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. I have a very small query. My participants are asked me. Actually, the pedagogy teaching workshop they attended,
right.
They are asking me that whether this workshop will be something different from pedagogy workshop.
Yeah.
I want to answer them, sir.
Yeah,
good
question.
Time?
So, I am happy. In fact, if they have attended the pedagogy workshop, they will benefit more, okay. Because this will be an extended version of whatever they studied there. There will be something more.
Okay. Okay.
So, as a matter of fact,
okay.
They will be able to appreciate okay. This perhaps better than other participants who are doing everything for the first time. So, the basic principles
yes, sir,
of
yes.
pedagogy, which will be reiterated, of course, they will know about them. But there is a lot more
okay.
material this time that you will find.
And it is a fresh perspective, specifically looking into blended and online instruction.
Right.
Whereas we focused okay. in pedagogy workshop, we were focusing on classroom instruction. Here we are focusing
okay.
More on the blended and online instruction, and hence all the modules will be aligned to that.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
But
thank you, sir.
Very nice of you and your participants to have raised this issue that are we getting the same material under a different bottle? So that is not correct. We are aware of that because we only conducted that workshop. So there is a definite material. As he rightly says,
okay.
You please tell them that this okay. is a there is a pedagogy element, but it is about online and blended education. And not about the classroom
okay.
training, which was emphasized in that workshop.
Right, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Let me go to Sri Ramakrishna Institute of Technology, Coimbatore.
Yes, sir. Very good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So this is Praveen Raja, Remote Center Coordinator and Workshop Coordinator of SRIT 1249. It is my privilege to thank NMEICT, IIT Bombay, and Professor Patak to receive. Rupees of 19 lakhs fund to conduct various kind of activities in our institute, including AVU upgradation also. Yeah, very thank you very much, sir, for receiving so much of fund in our institute through the NMEICT and IIT Bombay Government of India. Yes, and my question is, shall we assign the teaching assistant to this workshop? Now we have around 25 participants registered for this workshop. Shall we assign the teaching assistant for this workshop, and could you issue the certificates for them? This is my first question, sir. And my second question is there any schedules or session schedules? I'm asking the session schedules and the attendance details. Could you send the mail to the respective RCs or workshop coordinators?
Yeah. So let me answer the first question. Your third question?
Yes, sir. The last question is, my participants are attending the Saturday, Sundays, 3 days, 14, 15, and 4th and 5th of June, and 25th and 26th of June.
Right.
So it is a vacation, leave, Saturday weekend. So could you able to issue the at least participant certificate? It is my suggestion. Is it possible to issue the participant certificate to my participants? Or after completion of the successful Moodle assignments, then only they will receive the certificates.
Let me answer the questions in the order in which you ask them. First of all, we do not require any teaching assistants for this program. Teaching assistants are required to help people to do the lab assignments in that particular domain. So that is not required here. That is one. Second, what was the second question? I forgot.
The schedule and attendance and all.
So the schedule, basically all online activities are to be done by teachers individually as per their own time of convenience. There is no schedule. The schedule will be announced weekly. They will be doing that assignment. We are independently able to capture when they submit an assignment, when they do an online quiz, when they watch a video. All that is done through big data analytics at our end. So there is no question of attendance monitoring or anything during the 10 weeks of online interaction. Face-to-face interaction is when the group activity will be done. These are critical activities, and these activities form an integral part of the entire FDP. You cannot consider the FDP to be meaningful without these three weekend activities. So any participant who for a reason unable to participate in the face-to-face activity during the weekends will not be considered to have participated in the workshop at all. I think that you should make it very clear to participants. That is an integral part of FDP. Without that, FDP cannot be considered. Otherwise, we would have arranged only for an online course, no? The face-to-face interaction is meant for some specific group activity which cannot be conducted alone. So please tell all your participants that it is required that they must attend. If for some very emergency reason, if someone is not able to come, we will announce how to compensate for that absence by that person doing more work. But otherwise, a face-to-face activity is not to be considered separate from the online activity. Both activities together amount to the FDP. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Last three institutions. So I seek apologies for keeping them waiting for such a long time. This is School of Management Sciences, Lucknow. Over to you, Lucknow.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Yeah, we can see you and hear you clearly. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hello, sir. Hello, sir. Good evening.
Good evening. Please go ahead. Don't wait. I can
Hello.
Hear you very clearly. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir. Good evening. Am I audible? Hello. Thank you very much. In fact, I tried half an hour earlier, but couldn't get contact with you, sir. Sir, first of all, thank you very much for providing the opportunity to be associated with you. Sir, I have been in the workshop since the beginning, so almost all the points are clear. And if something or some doubts arise in future, we will try to contact you. One more thing, sir, I want to know, if there in case, how can I create the group? Is there any constraint of how many members can be in a group? Means I want to know the minimum number of participants that can form a group.
Can you repeat the last question? Keep the mic slightly away from your mouth so that we can hear you
Hello.
Clearly. Keep.
Hello. 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 Hello.
Yes.
Don't speak.
Hello. Sir, am I audible?
Please repeat the last question by keeping the mic slightly away from your face. Please go ahead.
Okay, sir. I just want to know what is the basis of formation of a group? What I have learned during the session, that is based on the domain. But some of the participants raised a question. For example, in a particular domain, there are only two candidates. Then can we create a group of only two candidates?
The submissions will have to be done individually for all the individual assessments and assignments, like multiple choice quizzes and submissions which are called for individual assessment or individual submissions. There will be a team assignment. There are different kinds of team assignments. One team assignment which they will have to do during the face-to-face interaction. That will be prescribed in great details in the coming week on the Moodle, and a separate note will be sent to the workshop coordinator on how to conduct that. The final team assignment, which will have to be done by teams of participants after the entire completion of these 10 weeks, will again be specified during the portion of this thing. So, right now, if the participants are worried, please tell them not to be worried about the team assignments. Enough explanations will be given whenever it comes for the team assignment work to be submitted.
Okay, sir.
Right. Thank you so much. Two more institutions and we are done. Marathwada Institute of Technology at Aurangabad. Over to you, Aurangabad.
Very good evening, sir.
Very good evening.
We are fine. Very good evening, sir. Very good evening, sir.
Good evening. Please go ahead.
Greetings from MIT Aurangabad. And we don't have any queries to ask because we have got sufficient information.
Okay.
It has been cleared. Right. And then we are very much thankful to you for providing us an opportunity. And we are almost registered about 50 candidates.
Very good.
From various institutes in and around Aurangabad.
Very good.
And it is a very good activity. And actually it is going to help the institutes at NBA level, at individual level, at institution level, and even also at NIRF level also, National Institute of Ranking Framework. So it is a very good activity. Thank you very much. Thank you. And my remote center coordinator want to talk to you.
Yeah, sure. Please go ahead.
Thank you so much for such kind of great patience. We seriously salute you. We have actually clarified all the doubts 45 minutes before only.
Okay.
But we have just waiting for greeting you. Thank you so much, sir.
So very nice
and,
of you.
Although, sir, I have only single doubt. Could I appoint one remote set AVU coordinator for this workshop?
You may please.
At least AVU coordinator.
Yeah, that's right. You may go ahead. We are not making any suggestions or observations. We are leaving all arrangements to the remote center. So, the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator can take a decision on what is most suitable and convenient to ensure that the workshop is conducted well. So, if you need a AVU coordinator, and in fact, you should have a AVU coordinator because there are three weekend sessions, and you saw that in two or three cases, unfortunately, the audio-video link broke down. Now, your link is working excellently. So, either you yourselves are expert users of AVU, or you have a background AVU coordinator who is helping you, whichever way is convenient.
No, sir, right now we don't have.
Okay.
Right now we don't have any AVU coordinator. The things are ideal there.
Okay. So it is fine. It is your call. You can take a call. I am perfectly happy with either way. And thank you very much for participating.
But sir, could you arrange some certificate for him? If I'm appointing an AVU coordinator, so we need to have some certificate to him or her.
We have not thought of that, but we would have typically RC coordinators and workshop coordinators. We certainly do not require any TAs, but if there is a AVU coordinator, I will consult my colleagues and take a call on this. I will let you know.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. The last session Rewa Engineering College. Oh, is that Rewa Madhya Pradesh? Hello, over to you.
Yes, sir. Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Okay, thank you, sir. Welcome to RCIT 135. Myself Gangaram Mandloi. I am RCC and workshop coordinator. Hello.
Yeah. Yes, yes. Please go ahead. What is the number you said? The RC number?
1350, sir.
Oh, 1350. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
This is just a new setup as a remote center. We are participating it first time. And it is just a government college. And facilities are available here, 30 seat, AC seat, with internet facilities, PCs, and 10 kVA power backup. UPS is also available in case of failure of any electricities. So, and I would like to thanks to for providing the fund 2.81 lakh to our institute for update the remote center facility.
Professor Panloi, since this is the last institute, I hope you do not mind I spend 3-4 minutes with you, because the name Rewa raises some very old and sweet memories in my mind. You may not be aware of this, but am I right in recalling that the college was set up in mid-60s?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, my father was posted as additional civil surgeon in Rewa then. I was an engineering college student at SGSITS Indore. And if I am not mistaken, okay. I had gone to Rewa to visit my father during the summer vacation, when the stone laying ceremony of the engineering college was done, I believe at the hands of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, if I am not mistaken. And I recall, I think I have attended that that ceremony. At least I know that a friend of mine was attending that engineering college, which started functioning a few years earlier. And he had told me that the classes were held in the arts college and the labs were conducted in the science college. And the workshop was being conducted in those days in the state transport workshop. So from that time, Rewa Engineering College has come to a very long way. I also recall, if I am not mistaken, my old friend and colleague who did his PhD here, Professor Khan, was posted in Rewa Engineering College for some time, but that was maybe 3 decades ago. So I am talking of very old times. As I said, the name Rewa raises some very fond memories. I am so very happy to see so many of you waiting patiently for more than 2.5 hours when the entire interaction has happened and you are at the end, and yet your enthusiasm is boundless. I am thankful for that, and I am also happy to welcome you as the remote center conducting this workshop. As you know, in every engineering college in the country, we have a problem of how to enhance our effectiveness as teachers in the growing load of students. And without using in technology, it will be impossible. So I am very happy that you have actually started the participation as remote center with this FDP. Welcome to this, and I look forward to great contributions in coming months and years from your college. Thank you so much.
And another facility is also available here, sir, as a podium machines, which was purchased from Singapore.
Oh, I see.
For deliver online lectures.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
It's all right, sir.
Right.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Let me see if there